What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Remy Ma. Welcome to Chrome 23. Queens get the money card. We have Stavia versus Yoshi G. First, I want to say, Yoshi, thank you for making it to the face-off. That means a lot to me. I know when you feel like it, you could not show up. But thank you for being here. And same thing for you. I'm not all jokes, but where do we start? I guess we'll start with the first thing that I feel like I was getting from a lot of people. It's my first card. It's my first event. That it should just been all vets. Like, certain people feel like, you know, who should have been on it, who shouldn't have been on it. What makes it? I want both of you to answer the question. What do you feel makes you valid to be on this card as opposed to over somebody who is considered a vet or, you know, top tier or whatever the case may be?
I feel like, you know, I get why most of the fans did want me on the card, but there were some who were saying, like, you know, she hasn't been around long enough. But I think that what I did in 2021, just the consistency of in performance and lyricism, I think that that's enough to be able to, like I kind of prove myself, you know.
Yeah,
so
what happened that you did in
2021? So in 2021, I was undefeated. Nah.
I was killing it.
I was killing it. No, but it was a good year for me. So it was, you know,
What about you, Yosh?
To say that only the vet should be on the card, I don't agree with that, only because not all of the vets I feel are currently relevant in the culture of what we have as female battle rap.
Okay.
And so what I was hoping was that you would make sure to include the most relevant girls.
Yeah, that's true.
And, you know, at the time, there's no name said more than Yoshi and Prestavia, so.
Uh-oh, no name said more than
I have.
Okay, so let's get right into it. So I think it's an overall consensus, like, people consider you a Christian rapper. Do you feel like you have to change your angle or the way that you're coming into it, considering that it's a very high possibility that Yoshi's gonna come with thought bars? Like, how does Christian bars interact with thought bars? How do they, like,
listen, I believe in God, I serve God, you know, but I don't think that takes away from, you know, I don't know how she's going to come, but it's not going to take away from anything that I have to say. So I'm not intimidated by, you know, the thought bars. I feel like I have, you know, that's a thing. That's her thing. That's what she do. So
yeah, I'm a Christian rapper too.
Right. That's what I'm listen, there's a few of them that
my father's a pastor.
So why would, I'm going to ask Joshi, why do you think someone that is considered a Christian rapper, kind of considers themselves that, mm-hmm. would join a crew called Gun Tigers?
Just because I think the group that they were trying to get her to join was so cliche, you know what I mean? And so it adds a different layer to her. I kind of like how Surf explains it, like, we do all of the dirt and then she prays for us, make sure we're good, because that's what grandma do, that's what mom do. It's like an angel in our corner.
So we're not gonna hear no gun bars from you?
Listen, you listen to my other battles, you hear some gun bars. I made it clear. I made my position clear and I explained, you know, what I explained in my battles. So you might.
I'm loving this whole camaraderie.
I'm just trying to decide if I'm gonna use thought bars.
Okay.
I've been deciding if I wanted to go into 2022 with a rebranding.
Okay.
Or do I want to stick with what people love and what got me here? So that's something that I'm...
Well, why not just do a combination of
some duality. Duality is always nice. But I still want to be organic to my journey. So I'm not the same little thotty when I first came in 5 years later. So
this is probably the most calm and unproblematic that I've ever seen. And maybe it's because Prestavia is calm and unproblematic and non-controversial. But it seems like you be having an issue with every girl in battle rap. Like, they feel, and this is like, I've heard it from enough people, they feel like you just be trolling them. Like, so I guess, am I going to ask them, do you feel that you be trolling them? And if you do, why do you be trolling them?
Yes, and like I was saying, I came into the game as a celebrity gossip blogger, which is like the worst kind. So, you know, Love & Hip Hop, Basketball Wives, those shows, I blog on them, I recap them, and I talk a lot of shit. And so somebody kept telling me, you should transition into battle rap because that's basically all you're doing is breaking people down. So I still have that mindset, that troll mindset. The when you do celebrity gossip, you literally have to almost stop them or watch their every move, watch the thing that they post, watch the thing that they delete, the ins and outs. And so I took that into battle rap. So I watched the girls. I trolled them. I comment on things that I see that they do that may be contradictions or hypocrisy. And for
and
them,
like that.
No, and nobody would. And it's something that I'm glad that I got the opportunity to start to try to see the girls in a different light. Like, they're regular girls. I don't have to always see official as official. She can be just Jessica. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah,
because
we went out last night and we had a
right.
good time. Like, I think
you did. You
fine.
Sure did. You did.
Okay, so let's talk about the elephant in the room. People have been accusing Yoshi of having a ghostwriter. Do you feel intimidated by that? Like, are you writing thinking that I'm going against Yoshi or I'm going against Yoshi and God knows who else? Like, is that
No, I mean, I definitely think, okay, I'm probably have to battle multiple people, but I'm prepared to battle multiple people because, unfortunately, that's the reputation of, like, not just her, but some of the other girls. So I already know... You know, I pride myself, like, I write my own stuff 100,000,000%, so you ain't gonna never hear that around me. However, it's like, then I said, like, I'm gonna have to just smoke your ghost. Like, I'm just gonna have to battle your ghost. Just have to battle your ghostwriter then, if that is the case.
So now I'm gonna flip it. Do you feel like, because I know yes stands on that, do you feel like if you do beat her, people are gonna say it wasn't you, it was. Imaginary writer number
right,
one.
Right, right. Yeah, when I go crazy, they're going to say that. But the thing that I fuck with is we MCs, right?
Mm-hmm.
The girls that's saying, I don't want to battle Yoshi because she may have a nigga helping her, want to battle niggas. So make it make sense to me as to what do you think that you could do with a top-tier man, but you're scared of me and as a woman... Because you think a man may be helping me. That don't make sense to me. So I feel like it's kind of pussy. It's a cop-out. If y'all want to battle the guys, you should be willing to battle anybody. Because
well,
them niggas...
It's crazy that you bring that up about not wanting to battle you. Because what I got a lot from not wanting to battle you is because you're not on that level yet. You haven't reached that level. You still are going through the ranks before you get to top tier or whoever should be
battling. I always thought it went back to those rumors.
Mm-hmm. But I didn't get that. That was some of it, but the more one, it was just like the same reason why you're on the card or you should. But Prestavia, you've been in it less than even Yoshi, but I hear a lot of people seeing you battle some of the vets. Like, so what do you think is the bias there? Because you having less time than Yoshi,
right.
But people want to see you battle some of the vets, and you having more time than her, and probably, like you said, your names have been talked about a lot.
Yeah,
in the
I think it worked for a long time. My rookie year, it was working like Yoshi haven't did enough. But at this point, I'm in my prime. I've battled on every platform. I've battled men, women, up, down, all around. So that excuse to me is just a weak excuse. You can't say I haven't done enough.
But that's like vicariously, like, so nobody like wants to, like, if I'm a battle Arsenal, I want to battle Arsenal because
right.
there's some perks that comes with that. But if, say, Arsenal is writing for you, that's not the same. I don't get the same leverage. You know what I mean?
Right.
Okay. And you're not Arsenal. You know what I mean? So, like, so yeah, who wants to battle somebody vicariously through another? I totally get it because I don't want to do it, but I realize that that's what it is.
Right.
So it's like, well, I'm just going to turn out every battle that...
That
you know, you have that this person has that reputation, or am I just going to go 10 times harder?
Yeah, I don't even think about stuff like that. I'm battling whoever they put in front of me. It could be my mom. What's
not
up?
My mom.
No, I'm about
okay, so let's ask this. What makes Yoshi a good opponent for you?
I thought, because I actually put Yoshi on my 2020, like, you know, person I want to battle list, because I thought it would be a good conversation. I thought people would like this clash, you know, because they create their own narratives in their head. Oh, the Christian versus the thought, self-proclaimed, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I just thought that people would like the conversation, and that's why I personally like
she's even still.
No, I agree.
The thought, self-proclaimed.
Yeah.
No, people been trying to get me. I didn't say it. You said people been trying to get me need to battle one of the Christians battlers since I got in here. Like, okay. Oh, that's your brand? You gotta battle Loso. You gotta battle Saga. You gotta battle Eivor. So I've always heard it. So when I heard it was a female that's coming in and kind of like repping it, I'm like, this is perfect because I can have a woman-to-woman conversation. I don't want to hear what y'all mean on this day because y'all gonna say the same thing just in a biblical, theological way. I want to hear it from a sister. Mm-hmm. So I'm excited as well for the conversation.
Okay, you guys are too nice to me. So with this card, there are some bonuses involved. We have a bonus for Battle of the Night, where each party is going to get a bonus if they're part of Battle of the Night. We have best three rounds of the night, where every single one of your rounds is crazy.
Oh, okay.
You get a bonus. And then we have a body of the night, where you just killed the other person so bad, like it was embarrassing.
Oh, I'll just take the crown for that one.
Oh, so you're going for a body of the night.
No. You know what? I think I like the battle of the night. I like the battle of the night too. And I feel like we did a lot of promo already with the whole, this was supposed to be on Midnight Madness. Mm-hmm. So we got a heads up on promo from the other girls.
Yes.
And so we can use that to have the momentum. We have a great back and forth. We're hungry and passionate. We don't have some of the stigmas that the vets have that they feel like they've already accomplished so much, they passed their pinnacle, they're not gonna push their pin. And I think the Battle of the Night is almost ours. It's like, okay. I'm already
speaking
looking
of Midnight
like
Madness, shout out to Surf for helping me make this happen here. I'm glad you were of assistance. And you guys are still gonna be going for a belt. Even though you're here,
you're still battling for the belt.
Even though it's going to come with
the
money card,
the belt.
Surf is coming with the belt. So I'm excited to see who's going to leave.
Is it pretty?
Have
you seen it?
No, I have not seen
it. I've tried it on my wall and everything. It's beautiful. Oh my God.
So you already got a place for it.
You know,
that's coming home.
Purple Muffet. I mean, you know.
Let me see if there's anything that I missed. I mean, like I said, you guys, I'm flabbergasted. You guys are so nice to each other.
Gosh, well, you gonna get some drama. You're gonna get some drama. Trust me, this is the introduction.
Alright, so with that being said, I mean, is there anything that either one of you want to get off your chest, y'all want to say? We still got some time before this battle comes up. Ain't nobody trying to
disclose
any information.
After this, y'all gotta stop ducking. Stop with the excuses. Oh, Yoshi haven't did enough. Oh, Yoshi don't write this. Or Yoshi don't. Stop with the narratives. Come outside and show me. Put that energy in a round.
Come outside.
Wrap it to me. Wrap all of that shit that y'all tweet. Wrap it to me.
Who
are
you talking to, though?
Yeah, name drop. You gotta put some names in it.
Or is it just everybody? Because it seems
it's
like
just
I don't see anybody that you don't want to
battle.
You know
what? I want to battle everybody. And if you're not on this card, I definitely want to battle you. I'll just leave it at that.
Okay. P, anything you want to say in closing?
No. Thank you, Ruby. I don't have anything to say.
Amen.
I got a lot to say.
Yes.
That's it.
All right, guys. That's for Stavia, Yoshi, Queens Get the Money card. We'll see what happens.
Live streaming provided by Hot 97 on hot97.com.